you for our early rise. Father God, we just thank you for starting us on our way. Father God, we ask that you bless our pastor, Reverend Dr. R.B. Holmes. Bless his family, Father God. Father God, we ask that you help us increase in our faith. We just thank you. We just believe and we thank you. Father God, we understand and we realize that because of your word, we are here. Father God, we come understanding that without you, where will we be? We stand in the need of a blessing. You know all our needs, Father God. Just touch us one by one. Father God, strengthen us. Father God, we just thank you right now. Father God, just remove all doubt and help us right now. Help us to walk in the Spirit, to live in the Spirit, that we may serve you better. Father God, just thank you. We thank you and help us to make that preparation so that we will be worthy, walk around in heaven. We just thank you right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. You. the lights are quiet. Thank you so kindly, Brother Virgin. Deacons led us in devotion. Our ushers and media ministry and security ministry and all of you who have come to worship. Amen. Appropriate selection of quiet or a song that you paid attention to the tie in so nicely with the message. You can call the witness. Brother Davis, Marvin's good to see you. As you pray for Brother Thomas Cox and passing of a brother on yesterday evening, God will bless him and Diane. We want to ask your blessings for all of our members who are sick and shut in. I thank you for coming to church. God bless each and every one of you. Media ministry, I want to give you two scriptures, but if you don't mind, let's go to St. Luke, the second chapter, also in the 49th verse. St. Luke. Second chapter, the 49th verse, will include my text for this morning, my preaching references. You read in the book of Luke during the month of February. If you do what I'm doing, reading a chapter per day, you should be right at the 11th chapter. Are you doing it? We're in church now, amen? I will do it, Pastor. I'll catch up. Luke 2:49. You can't go wrong reading God's word today. It is the word of God. And he said unto them, how is it that ye sought me? Wist ye not that I must be about my Father's business? Took over to St. Luke, the 9th chapter, and the 6th and 7th verse. Luke 9, verse 6 to 2. And Jesus said unto him, no man, having put his hand to the plow and looking back, is fit for the kingdom of God. Then tiptoe to Philippians, the 1st chapter that we studied on Thursday, is that movement by me. Philippians 1 and 6. Being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Eternal God, thank you for this day in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for calling us to be a part of your ministry, mission, works and program. Thank you for blessing us to be here one more time. We're learning how to take these days for granted as if so. It is because of your grace, your saving grace, your sustaining grace, your strengthening grace that we are here another.
sick and shut in among us. Bless our families, our households, those who lost loved ones. Comfort them. Now, Master, Maker, Creator, Savior, Lord, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight. My Lord, my God, my strength, and my Redeemer. Let me decrease, please, sir, and your Holy Spirit increases. In Jesus' name. Amen. I want to use for a subject this morning, do something. The theme that the Woodward High football coach of Florida State University, William Tagler, has the theme hashtag do something. He inserted this slogan after he inherited a very depleted incoming football recruits after Jimbo Fisher left FSU. Coach Tiger had a decision to make. Should he sit around and complain about many recruits changing their minds by playing for FSU, or should he do something? Get out there and do the good work of finding new recruits. Coach Tiger started class rated 64. His recruiting class made the top 10. Life always will challenge us. What will we do when life gets rough and tough? What do we do when the odds of success appears to be working against us and not for us, such as sickness, lostness, brokenness, emptiness, loneliness, disappointment? I want to suggest to you, when these moments and seasons come, to get up and do something. The old familiar slogan of Nike is, just do it. The text says, don't stop doing good work. Don't quit on being about the Lord's business. Jesus and discovered a day later that Jesus knocked with him. And they came to find him. They found him in the church, dealing with the lawyers, scribes, and Pharisees about his ministry. He said to his mother, "I must be about my father's work, my father's business." Philippians 1:6 says, "Being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ." Do something. The theme song to the highly acclaimed movie, Marcia, profiling the works and life and bravery of the great first African-American member of person to sit on the highest court of the land, the Supreme Court, Thurgood Marshall. Is "Stand for Something," composed by Andrea Day and Kong. Stand for something. You can have all the money in your hand, all the possessions anyone could ever have, but all worthless treasure. True worth is only measured not by what you got, what you got in your heart. You can have everything. What does it mean? It all means nothing if you don't stand for something. You can't just talk the talk. You got to walk the walk. Yes, you do. It all means nothing if you don't stand for something. We must put our faith in action. Faith, I told you last Sunday, without words, is dead. The Apostle Paul is urging us to do something. Stand for something. To find something good to do and stick with it. Stay focused. God will help you to finish that which you have begun. And when you start this journey for the Lord, please, brothers and sisters, don't turn back. Jesus said in Luke 9:62, "And Jesus said unto them, after asking men to come follow him, three of them made excuses for why they cannot do the good work of the Lord. And Jesus said unto him, No man or woman ever put his or her hand to the plow, and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God." Brothers and sisters, we notice now why many people are missing their blessing, their joy, and their peace is because they are looking back. They stop doing the good work. Something happened in the course of life where you're not here. You give up and stop serving the Lord. I've been trying to tell you this year, if you know Jesus, show enough knowing deep down in your soul. If you know him, you will love him. this very thing. That he which has begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. In this verse, Paul gives us three encouraging thoughts that will enable us to do something and stand for something. First, Paul speaks about the author of the good work. Verse 6 and 8 clause. The author of the good work. We know that Jesus is the author of peace and purpose and passion and principle. The devil is the complete opposite. He is the author of confusion, conflict, disunity, discord, dissension. But when God created the heaven and earth, when he got through creating this thing, he said it is good and very good. And told Adam and Eve, be about your Creator's business. Turn this fertile ground, turn this heavenly place into a place that be fruitful and productive. Adam, be about the Lord's business. He's the author of the good work. Because the opposite, I feel this thing here, of good works is no works. Bad works. Incomplete work. Inconsistent work. We learned in the Sunday school this morning that integrity means being consistent. The lack of integrity is being inconsistent. Even with your tongue. See, your tongue can do good works out of your mouth. Bad works. You can, and one day you can praise God the same tongue. The next day you can profane. James said, listen, don't not be so. When you attempt to do something, to be about something, to do some good works, you need to know that this work is providential. It is about the Lord's will for your life. Look at verse 6-8. Being confident of this very thing. Confident means full assurance. Sure, without doubt. but he. He is not you. But he is not your money. But he is not your job. And thank God that he is not the stock market, because it changes. Men can regulate and dictate. It is man driven, it's carnal driven, it's not God driven. It's driven by folk on Wall Street and not Main Street. You got your faith in stocks and bonds, and not in him who is able to keep you from falling. But he is not the government. The government has shut down for the least price in the last several weeks. You slept me last week. Who is the he that you have confidence in? Can I help you this morning? My he is the Alpha and Omega. My he is the maker and creator of all things. My he is the rose of Sharon. My he is the bright and morning star. My he is the rock of my salvation. My he is the Lord mighty in battle. My he is the joy in the time of sorrow. My he is my peace, my friend, my savior, my provider. Have confidence in the author of this good world. He is sweet, I know. I know the man who is advertising Dr. Pepper. He says that he's the super. But David said, taste and see that the Lord is sweet. Come on, he got a look. Something positive and stand for something. You must know who is the author of this good work. Being confident of this very thing. Whatever your thing is, when it comes to Jesus, you ought to be confident that he's in it. Being confident, whatever he calls you to do, if you're a parent, you have to be confident in this very thing, that the Lord will take care of your household. If you're a senior citizen, you got to be confident of this thing, that the Lord didn't bring me this far to leave me. You got to be very confident. This very thing that he which has begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. The second point is the attitude about the good work. Remember last Sunday I talked to James 2 about the attitude something valuable and meaningful that will change lives and make a lasting difference with a bad attitude. You won't continue, you'll start, but you won't continue to do good works until you change your attitude. We need the fruit of the Spirit. If you're going to do good works, my attitude has to radically change from being a bad, negative attitude. Paul says in Galatians 5:22, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, self-control. We need the fruit in us if we're going to maintain a good attitude. Here it is, here it is. Being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you. The work is in you, not in the system, not in other people doing for us what we ought, what the great do for ourselves. The work, thank you, Holy Spirit, is in you. And Paul said, you got to stir up the gift that is. Are you up here this morning? In you. The key, I want to just take my time. The key to understanding this principle is the word in. From Master Brown, what part of speech is the word in? Is that a preposition? That's right. In. He who has begun. The master got A+, and grandma, I got C+. Miss Holmes got A++. Take a look at these words here. In is a simple word. You got to decide what's going to come before you. Will it be seen? Is Christ in me? He has begun a good work in you. Not over you, not around you, but in you. Just going to raise a good question in our Christian education seminar. She said, Pastor, we have to keep the motivation going. What she said, Pastor, we got to make sure that what we're saying here, that we can't just talk about it. We just talk the talk, but we gotta start walking the walk. We can say about it, we can even preach about it, but what can we be about it? What's gonna keep me motivated after the benediction is not on the inside of me. What's gonna motivate me when time to get off? Come down to what's on the inside. Dr. Charles Wright raised the question. He said, Pastor, we have to teach our folk how to understand the importance of budgeting finance, because we spend too much money on chips, candy, and dollar bills. Until we understand who we are and whose we are, we'll still be talking about slavery and not trying to transform our mindset to
misunderstanding time.
That argument, the newspaper yesterday, my preacher talked about Glenn and talked about the people that she runs in contact with, and all of them have and Jesus healed. What about the one he did not heal? God says he did something. He did it. Went back to the altar. Went down to the altar. He healed Peter's brother man. That man came to the truth. Other people came to Jesus. And God says, what keeps us from the man? My dad would be dead almost 8 years. And he always had to talk about it. A booth home. I went around Bethel. I went around a negative household. Wasn't not a rich household, but it was a good household. My mom told my sisters to sit down. And she played a Aretha Franklin song. A natural woman. And Mama critiqued that thing. It's a Derek Josephine, Betty Barber, don't ever lose your soul and put it in lost and found. For he who controls your soul will control your death. So you can be a natural woman without having an unnatural man. And all them got married. And gave my mom good son-in-laws and gave me good brother-in-laws because they had a good one. You won't get weary of them, do you? When Christ is in you. What keeps us going? Bad times, confusing times, misunderstanding times, is our attitude of our pride, worship, trusting, and giving our best to God. The theme song said, it all means nothing if you don't stand for something. You can't just talk the talk. You've got to walk that walk. Yes, you do. It all means nothing if you don't stand up for something. And I stand for you. And I stand up for you. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. She said, you do the best. Do the best that you can do. That you can look some lessons on faith. Listen, Jesus will finish whatever he started. Jesus will finish whatever he started. Jesus is a finish. Lindsey Vonn, but the great scheme is in Zachariah. And what great, what a gracious word. When she interviewed, she said, I'm doing this lastly in memory of my grandfather. Because my grandfather taught me this scheme. And I believe that I'm going to achieve, I'm going to affirm it because my grandfather died on the 1st of last year. And she wrote her grandfather a letter. She said, Grandfather, I'm here because of you. Grandfather, I appreciate what you've done for me. And then she said, Grandfather, please look out for me. What she was saying is, I need somebody. I need my grandfather. If I'm going to finish, I got to lean on the spirit of my grandfather. But I got a better father. He's my heavenly father. And I've got good news, and he will look out for me. Anybody know what I'm talking about? He will look out for me. He will. He said it is finished on the cross. He said it is finished. What Jesus does in this church, he will finish. What Jesus starts in your life, Jesus will finish it. Somebody needs this fresh affirmation. Your best work is still before you. Your best work is still before you. Say it again, Pastor. Your best work is still before you. You got to be like Rocky. You don't stand up for something. You can't just talk the talk. You got to walk the walk. Yes, you do. It all means nothing if you don't stand up for something and stand for you. Stand for respect, dignity. If that's all you got, then you got all you need. And without that, you don't have nothing. Oh, no. The economy comes in and says, rise up. Lift your hand. I stand with you because I understand. Ain't here to judge, just to take a stand. The greater plan, the great cost plan. Let's all rise like the day began. Reach out and touch for the Savior's hand. On rock, we stand like the native land. Let the ways of love be the ways of man. And all mean nothing. You don't stand for something. You can't just talk the talk. You got to walk the walk. Yes, you do. It all means nothing. You don't stand for something. And I stand up for you. I stand up for you. Yes, I will. Yes, I will stand up for you. Do something, and you will stand for something. Be confident of this very thing. That he which has done a good work will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Dr. Harold? Stand you can't stand. Do something. Don't go through Black history and don't understand what your ancestors, our foreparents, left us with. Do something. First thing first, do something about your shoulder. never given Jesus Christ your life, do something. Ask him this morning to save you, because he's on the right hand of the Father, interceding on your behalf. Do something about where you're going to spend eternity. What do? You walk by faith. We're saved by grace through faith. If you hear, I want to pray for you. If you've never been baptized, never given Christ your life, do something. As I pray for you, come down now. Accept the gift of eternal life. Secondly, if you hear and you speak, if you don't have a church, you're not actively involved in ministry at the local church. I want to pray for you. Do something. Do something. Don't walk out of here unsaved by the church. Do something. Thirdly, many of us in this capital, you saved, and this is your church home. I want to urge you to do something. Do some good work. We've laid out a ministry, a vision, where everybody, anybody can be engaged. Don't let folk run you away from the presence of the Holy Spirit. I'm not perfect, but if I would listen to my naysayers, I'd have been known before I started this ministry that God called me. And if I listen to what folks said, but I can't do it first to me, guys. If I had listened to what my first grade teacher said to me, I'd have walked around very inferior. Did you say I would never even learn to talk correct? I stuttered. After Jesus Christ. Folk told me, you've been with boys, you can't be a wife of a wicked boy. See, you've been down, you've been out. The folks said, it's all over. Why did God spare you? Why did God help you get over that embarrassing episode in your life? Because he be February 11th. God is not finished with you yet. Do something. In the name of Jesus, we're going to lay out the master's plan. Eternal God, first and foremost, thank you, sir, for thinking enough of me to call me into this ministry of preaching, teaching, healing, encouraging, mobilizing, motivating, enriching. I thank you, sir. The Sunday school lesson reminds us, if you're going to be a spiritual teacher, you can't take it lightly. And I thank you for the call. And thank you for allowing this servant to preach your word. And thank you for the media ministry. Such a partner in making sure that we can visualize what this little word is saying in such critical times in this world. So I thank you. There's somebody here that want to do something, but they can't do good works unless they've been saved. Then God will create us to be workers. So I pray they'll do. Somebody needs a church home here. They need a place where they can tell folk, I'm saved and I worship at the Bethel Church. We got to be that kind of authentic witness. Folk want to see our good works. And we give all credit to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. The group that him that saved and in church, but we got to be more than just being in church. We need Christ in us. We need him. And whatever it is that in a sad place, a dreary place, a frustrating place, that's not the Spirit of God. Where the Spirit of God is, there's liberty. There's forgiveness. There's renewed strength. And I can't just stay stuck because somebody hurt my feelings. gonna put you on the back burner. Gotta keep giving, keep worshiping, keep sacrificing, keep believing, keep praying. Do something. Thank you, Lord, you did something. You paid the ultimate price. And John 3:16 does record in Jesus. Will you come? Will you come? Will you come as a candidate to be baptized? Will you come? As